Imagine if one day you woke up and the same person is on the inside, but the outside does not match. And none of that is who you are. These woods, my thing was I used to, you know, play pretend all the time in here. I mean, escapism for me was like my entire childhood. There wasn't a lot of space for me, so I had to make a space for myself.
Hi, buddy. Come here, big beetle. Come here.
I didn't have anyone that I identified with, I guess. There wasn't anyone out there that was like me that I was aware of growing up. My 15th birthday was coming up, and I knew that if I had to spend another birthday as the birthday girl, I was not going to have another birthday. So in the summer before my sophomore year, I transitioned, and when I returned to school, I returned as Gavin and a male student. And so I went to my school and I said, hey, can I use the boys' bathroom? And they said, yeah, why not? And so for 7 weeks, I used the boys' room and it was fine. There was zero issues whatsoever. And regardless of this, a school board meeting was held where they discussed in a public setting my genitals and bathroom usage.
You are looking for future sex violations, future rapes, sex in bathrooms. Our pregnancy rate's gonna go up, STD rates are gonna go up, and it's gonna be a hard time in Gloucester County.
I drive a Mustang. I can put it in a garage full of Porsches. It'll never be a Porsche. It'll still be a Mustang. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I'm 15, and I'm sitting there, and I'm insecure, and I'm afraid. And I'm hearing adults that I've lived alongside for 15 years dehumanize me in any way they knew how. I, at the time, was still wearing a binder, and these things ride up often, and it will bunch up on your ribs and in uncomfortable places. I mean, I'm uncomfortable. But there was no question in my mind I was going to participate in the school board meetings.
I cannot use the women's room, quite frankly, because I'm not a girl. All I want to do is be a normal child and use the restroom in peace. And I have had no problem from students to do that, only from adults. The adults are the only people who have been trying to restrict my rights. I am not the only transgender student in Gloucester County, and I deserve the rights of every other human being. I'm just a human. I'm just a boy. Please consider my rights when you make your decision. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
My name is Ira Johnson. I was born the year the Civil Rights Act was passed. And diversity and inclusion is the way we go forward. Everything else is in the past. The school board, I know y'all don't want to deal with this situation, but that's what y'all were elected for. So I ask that y'all include the rights of this child, because I'm sure there's more children in the shadows.
Students with gender identity issues shall be provided an alternative, appropriate private facility. That's my motion.
All those in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Any opposed?
No. They decided that I was either to use the women's restroom at school or these unisex restrooms that they had constructed out of broom closets. Ultimately, the decision set the course of the next 2+ years of my life. And then we got the decision that the Supreme Court was going to take my case.
It's on the front page of the New York Times. Teenage voice leads the fight on restrooms. Did you read the story that she wrote about you, Kevin?
There's a lot of misconceptions about what transgender means, and it's a hard concept to wrap your head around. Like, I'd never heard of it. And I don't really have a problem with it being hard to wrap your head around. What I have a problem with is people not even trying to wrap their head around it.
My father, he wouldn't even attempt to interact with me, and he would barely even acknowledge that I existed. And then when he would acknowledge that I existed, it was to criticize something I was doing or to kind of treat me badly. And I felt guilty because I thought it was my fault that he wasn't showing me any love. And he didn't. I mean, he didn't show it ever, ever. And I'd say that to his face now.
I'm a whole lot old-fashioned. Even growing up, I mean, boys do this, girls do that, you know? Everything is black and white for me. So when he first come out, it was pretty hard. You know, I was angry, I was hesitant, I was dismissive, I was, you know, all the normal feelings that you might feel.
Early on, I don't think he knew how many behind-the-scenes fights I had for him. Not just with Dad, but within our whole family. Part of it is there are religious beliefs involved that some people can't come to terms with, and this has been very dividing for my family. Good.
We might make this a little shorter.
I would like it to be shorter.
But if it's too short, what happens is it will look a little bit too boxy. Put your arms down for a second.
We made the shoulders a little bit bigger.
Right, but he likes the shoulders.
Yeah, yeah,
you know what I mean?
Yeah.
If he's comfortable, that's all there is to it.
Don't touch my shoulders.
We'll give you your shoulders.
I mean, if y'all think it needs to be taken.
No. It's much more natural, I think, this way.
That's such a handsome face.
How you feeling? Good.
I love it. It's not
good. I feel so silent.
It's so.
Hello, Gavin.
Hey. So good to meet you.
It's good to meet you as well.
Very nice.
Thank
to meet you.
So
you have no idea.
I am just happy to meet you, and I'm happy that you're doing what you're doing.
Thank you.
And stay strong, people. March 28th, it'll be what it's gonna be. This case is going to the Supreme Court with you because you're the one who can handle it. God doesn't give us more than we can handle, and here you are. But how does one, at 17 years old, bear the weight of this?
Having this platform, it's not something that many people ever get. I can't waste it or, you know, not use it for positive change. But then in my personal life, it's been really interesting to adjust to. Mm-hmm. It's just a sort of these mundane, like, domestic things that right now I can't think about, I can't focus on. But of course there's things I would like to have in my future, eventually.
Yeah. Hey everybody, look who's here.
And I just wanted to update everybody on my public page that's following and let y'all know who I got to meet.
Yeah, I'm so inspired by Gavin this moment I heard about his story, the moment I heard about your story. And often in our country's history, it is one person who didn't want to be famous, didn't want to be of note, but stood up for what was right, and they changed the course of history. And I think that could be you, Gavin. I think that is you.
Well, I hope so. I hope this is a good thing.
I heard support from people in other countries, from younger kids, from teachers and lawmakers.
Hey, Gavin.
Gavin. Sarah here in Paris. Just wanted to show you my love and support.
I'm Hildy. I'm transgender too. I stand with you.
And we stand with Gavin.
I even had the support of some major tech companies like Apple, Spotify. I mean, just any corner of the conversation you could think of, I had some voice in that mix that was pulling for me, and it was just really, really powerful.
I love you, Gavin!
In one of the first major acts of Attorney General Jeff Sessions, the Justice Department has just an hour ago rescinded anti-discrimination protections for transgender students, protections that had been advanced by the Obama administration. This comes after a little notice court filing by the Justice Department just one day after Sessions became Attorney General.
Name on Trump, protect trans students.
What could happen today does not mean my case ends, which is why we have gathered here outside of the White House, the People's House, to let it be heard that we will not be silenced and that we will stand with and protect trans youth. No matter what happens, no one, not even the government, can defeat a community so full of life, color, diversity, and most importantly, love.
Amen.
You know, the whole, like, premise of the argument that the other side raises is not trans people just by existing are threatening the safety of privacy of non-trans girls, which is, you know, offensive. And we just don't have any examples of ever a person pretending to be trans to go assault someone. And this is obviously just like a rhetorical means for advancing their, you know, desire to, you know, not have a world of shifting gender norms and not have a world of gay people, trans people. That's what it's really about.
Oh, fuck.
What?
Gloucester, judgment vacated and remanded.
God damn it.
Fuck.
All right, well, let me see the... It's not up on the website yet. Oh, here's the order list.
Well, I guess we're not going to D.C. After all that, Jesus.
Or... Yeah, I know.
Hey, Gavin. So, really, really, really sorry about this, obviously.
You know, it's frustrating, mainly because it keeps you and other trans kids, you know, in limbo for another year or two.
Right. Well, I mean, you know, if it takes 10 years, I'm in it.
Yeah, yeah, no, absolutely. Yeah, so are we.
I mean, it was never a guarantee. And it's disappointing because the whole point initially was to just be able to use the bathroom and have a hopefully normal rest of the school year. I, for so long, thought in terms of surviving a day and just anticipating that any day now I was just gonna call it quits and give up. I didn't make plans for the future just because I didn't think about having a future. I'm glad I stuck around. I mean, I have such a beautiful life now. And I have so much ahead of me that I have so many opportunities ahead of me. And there's so much that I can do with my life.
It's really great meeting you.
Thank you. Nice to meet you as well.
I'm pulling for you, and I hope everything, you know, your advocacy is super critical
Thank
for
you.
A lot of people.
Thank you. I appreciate that. This fight is for all trans youth who are in school or one day will be. It is for the friends and loved ones of these youth who want these children to be happy and healthy rather than at risk and in danger as so many trans people are. Treating trans students with dignity and respect should not be controversial.
The decision to withdraw the guidance sent a terrible message to some of the most vulnerable people that President Trump, the leader of our country, and his administration do not care about protecting you from discrimination. Regardless of what hatred or ignorance or discrimination we face, we will be fine because we have love on our side. That is something that even the withdrawing of the guidance cannot change. I have it?
Push phone, yeah.
Dad, I'm gonna be busy for the rest of today.
I didn't say today.
Well, tomorrow's graduation and then I'm out.
Right, and then you got push phone to do. Where are you out to?
Yeah, you're cute. I'm going to the Outer Banks for a week.
Oh, I forgot about that.
And I have to do a lot of touch-up, which I don't have the patience for.
I have five children, and all of my children are unique individuals in some way. And I love all five of them. And Gavin's no different. The fact that he is trans is going to be an uphill battle for him. I think he'll be fine, though. I think he'll do just fine.
Parents, guardians, grandparents, siblings, extended family and friends, all here today who have had a hand in raising this great group of young men and women, welcome to our 2017 graduates.
Gavin Elliott Grimm.